Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. In the SEC, there is one certainty. You never get a rest. You never get a chance to catch your breath. If you don't believe it, just try taking your C game or something to a place like Lexington or Nashville or Starkville. You know what'll happen? You'll walk out with a loss. You have to bring your best in every single game in the SEC. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Gainesville, Florida. Here the fans are getting noisy for what should be a high-powered football game. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Florida is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He'll return it from the three. And down he goes at the 29. Johnson's a guy we've seen, Kirk, when he plays on the road, he's almost like he wants to quiet the crowd and say, you know what, bring it, and I'll bring it right back to you.
Yeah, I think one of the things you have to do as a quarterback when you go on the road and you get in this kind of tough environment is get off to a fast start. And he told us this week one of the big things that he's trying to emphasize to his team is that it's not just to go out and win on the road. Let's take the crowd out of the game early by making some big plays, and then let's just go out and play our game.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He's going to try and scramble. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 32. Five wide. A little toss across the middle. They'll bring him down at the 39. Smith picks him up around 7 yards with that catch. It's away, and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Pitches back. And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
This is one of their special plays they like to call to keep the defense off balance. When you can get first downs in unconventional ways, you have the edge over your opponent.
From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. And they get nice yardage on that run. At midfield, and they push him out at the 44.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line.
Nice play, baby. Nice play. Now you're not looking up. You got tight left, tight left. Four down, four down. Watch 18. 18's the mic.
They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's gobbled up in the backfield. 2-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34.
Tight end, right. Four down. Mike 19.
Ham.
Black 8. Ham.
He's looking for 6. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. And this one is a beauty. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Florida's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Tailback gets 2 yards on the option. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on their own 22. He's pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Taken down around the 36-yard line.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. With the pass, incomplete. He gets rid of this one. And here's another third down. Passes it to the middle of the field. Tackle at the 47.
Impressive gain there by the do-it-all back.
He's at the 40. He's tackled at the 36-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. From the 31-yard line, second down. Throws it into coverage, and it's intercepted. He gets hit out of bounds at the 35.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
Their own 35-yard line. First down. And down he goes around the 37-yard line.
Tight left. Four down. Mark 18 for Mike.
We played one. Still no score. We're all tied up as we head into quarter number two. Just throws this one away. From their own 37-yard line, third down. Now he's scrambling.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
Gives it up the gut. Nice run up the middle. From their own 49-yard line, it's second down. Taken down at the 48.
I think calling the plays, you've got to be aware of this guy. He's making too many plays. And when he's that close to the line of scrimmage, defending the run, not allowing your running back to even get up to the line of scrimmage, you've got to do something to make him pay for that. If he's going to cheat up to the line of scrimmage, if you're calling the plays, listen up. This is a great time to go play action and try to throw the ball right over top of his head.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle made right around the 48-yard line. Palmer, back to return it. He really got a hold of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Hit as he threw, and he completes it.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Scrambling around. He's out to the 30. He dives, and he'll be marked down.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
Pick up of a yard for the tailback.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 33-yard line. Runs it right. Nice pickup. His receiver, and that's a first down. He's knocked out of bounds at the 50-yard line. From the 50, first down.
You can't block me. You can't block me. No, you can't block me.
Brought down at the 49-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
That was a great tackle. The defender seemingly came out of nowhere and put a big hit on the ball carrier.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at the 36. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 36.
Check, check,
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Fires that quickly, incomplete. It's the ninth play of the drive. He throws it. The Tigers are going to call their second timeout. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he's tackled
at about the five-yard line.
It's the 11th play of the drive.
Come on.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. It's third and goal from the five. Let's see if they can put this one in. He's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
This isn't much more than an extra point. LSU could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it's good. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Let's check in on the SEC where the supersonic speed defenses wreak havoc. And for South Carolina, they run the ball with attitude, a ground and pound attack that results in a touchdown. The Gamecocks have the edge, 14-7.
And we thank you, Reese Davis. Back to the action here. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 30.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Give to the tailback. Nice run to the left there. Pierce picks up five with the carry. From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen, and he shoved out of bounds around the 44-yard line.
That screen play was well executed. I'm not sure the defense was looking for it, and they weren't in great position to make a play until the first down was already picked up.
I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He heaves it deep. And he's immediately tackled. We've reached halftime, and we couldn't have asked for a better first half. 3-0, LSU. Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 33. LSU's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Watch one. Watch one.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. And they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From their own 32-yard line, second down.
Watch 18. 18's the mic.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. On the run, and they make the stop at the 44.
Smart call here to trust your line and the ball carrier to gain the yards they had to for the first down.
It's first and 10, ball on the 44. They'll drop him for a loss.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Fires it quickly, and he can't hang on to it. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. He's going to air it long. And he was that close to turning that into a big play. After the big pass play, we've got a first down. This offense has really stalled on their last two trips to the red zone. That's a great tackle at the 20-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Four down. Watch 18. 18's the mic.
Get down. 2-9.
Motion.
Swings it out left to the halfback. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. 2 for 2 so far on this drive. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
Here's a case of a quarterback so eager to make a play that he failed to see the danger of that attempt and nearly gave the ball away.
There was some movement on the line.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Fourth down and a ways to go after the penalty. Florida is down 3 and looking to tie it up. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and he splits the uprights. Here's an update from the studio in Reese Davis.
Old Hockey has the claws out, ready to go at Williams-Brice. Let's take yet another peek at this game. Here's a hotly contested battle. South Carolina on top, 17-14.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. Howard has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. What a collision. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice,
and execute when it's time.
Incomplete, almost picked off.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Man left, man left.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 27. Tough throw on the run and caught. And he's taken down
around the 34-yard line.
That's a 7-yard gain.
Hey, they picked up a nice gain of 7 yards on that play. Great pass.
Tackle right around the 34.
Copeland will be the return man. He puts it away, and it's a great kick.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
From their own 25-yard line.
Second down. He's tackled at the 38-yard line.
To him, and this time they get him in the backfield. It's second and 13.
Ball on their own 35.
I got one.
Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. So at the end of the third quarter, and this one's knotted up at 3. All tied up as we head to the all-important fourth quarter. We know their defensive coordinator is an excitable guy, and he couldn't be any more excited than he is right now. Huge, huge stop here in a tie game in the fourth quarter. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt.
This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
So early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession. Got an opening. He makes his way to about the 32. From their own 32-yard line, first down.
Draw, tackle in the backfield.
Sets up a screen, tailback's got it. He's taken down
around the 33-yard line.
It's third and 9. Ball on their own 33.
Check back 11.
Watch the motion.
40-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He really got a hold of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You look up at the clock, Herbie, and there's not a lot of time to make something happen here.
No, it's been ugly for both of these offenses. You got to think about maybe spreading out the defense, giving your quarterback a chance to either run or throw. Somebody's got to make a play here to determine the outcome of the game.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. Looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. That's a loss of 4 yards.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
It's third and long. Ball on their own 23. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line. Knocked out of bounds. Around the 50. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. A little over a minute in the game. Throws a laser across the middle. Brought down at about the 33-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 33.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
He gets hit out of bounds around the 27-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. They come out in a five wide set. He's tackled at about the 21. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out.
The offensive coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the fifth first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
and they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Well, I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
So here we go. It's third and goal from the four, and this would break the tie.
Might have been some early movement up front.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
And they make the stop at the one. So it's coming down to the kicking game. This to give them the lead. He gets it up. He got it. They win. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.